As early as the 19th century, comic books were using cross-sections and making walls of buildings invisible in order to let us see the people inside in the style of a doll's house. In a drawing by Marie Duval from the comic Ali Sloper's Comic Calendar, 1878, we can see the drunk title character being brought back to his lodgings in the middle of the night by a policeman, who ends up waking everyone in the building. By removing the outside wall, Duval lets us see the cramped rooms they live in and the humorous situations they wake up in. I've been reading comic books since I was old enough to remember. I've enjoyed the medium since that first encounter, and I'm still reading comics in the present day. I was born in a city, went to secondary school and university in a city, and still live in one today. The experience of reading comics and being a city dweller have been connected in my mind since I was young, and a great many comics are set in cities and comment on that experience, whether from the point of view of a superhero or an ordinary person. For my PhD research, I'm looking at the connections between comics and architecture. I'm exploring some of the urban environments we see in comics and how that helps people understand the experience of living in a city and the types of architecture that enable large numbers of people to live next to each other. They make the sounds of the building something that we can see and read on the page. This technique is still being used over 120 years after Marie Duval, with graphic novelist Karrie Fransman depicting similar juxtapositions in her graphic novel, The House That Groaned, which shows how the walls, floors, and doors that separate people can also bring them together. By reading comics set in cities, we can gain some insight into the situations that people find themselves in buildings where lives are going on next door to each other. Comics may find comedy or tragedy in these encounters, and hopefully the readers gain some knowledge about architecture, urban living, and comic book storytelling all at the same time.